फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू आवर चैनल के एम अचीवर्स. आई एम प्रणेश. टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कपलिंग रिएक्शन व्हिच आर वेरी यूजफुल फॉर इन ऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस. इन दिस चैप्टर आई चूज सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग फॉर नेट एग्जाम, बिकॉज व्हाट अबाउट द क्वेश्चन केम इन प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन पेपर इन नेट एग्जाम, दैट टॉपिक आई सिलेक्टेड बिकॉज नेक्स्ट टाइम इट विल सो कम फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक ओनली एंड दे आर आस्किंग नो अबाउट दिस एंड फ्यूचर परस्पेक्टिव आई चूज दिस. See, coupling reaction, whatever we study in previous, it is called Heck reaction. You know already, you know this, what is Heck reaction. And this is normally coupling reaction, Heck reaction. And this is, next topic is cross coupling reactions. Means this is a, cross coupling means coupling between one organometallic compound in organic halide. And simple coupling means, coupling reaction means you have to, like Heck reaction, it is a normally alkyl halide and one double bond. Okay, here is organometallic compound coupled with the alkyl halide in presence of catalyst. In this first coupling reaction, I choose this Suzuki coupling, this is Dilley coupling, and this is Sonagashira coupling. These three coupling is a very useful coupling reaction in organic synthesis, and you have to know this, what about this. But here I teach you about this short technique for remembering, and only the practical application, not a in-situ application, only practical application I will show you. Okay, next is one important topic, it is come only net exam, that's why I choose, because hydropalladition and dehydropalladition can lead to alkene isomerization. Means if hydropalladization means if you use catalyst and palladium catalyst, that time it will generate hydropalladium, then it will remove this elimination reaction happen, and that will, the double bond means alkene means alkene isomerization, means shifting of double bond to this position to that position by using palladium catalyst. That's I will teach you. Next is that is allylic electrophiles are activated by palladium. Hi friends, now I explain here from Heck reaction. Before going to inside of Heck reaction, I have to explain about nature catalyst and their reaction mechanism, about the catalytic cycle, that I will little bit explain, you have to see. See, in this Heck reaction, before going to Heck reaction, here see, I choose one catalyst, it is called palladium tetrakis triphenylphosphate. You know, you already know this catalyst. It is an triphenyl phosphine is there for both, and its oxidation state is zero. Okay, so if it is oxidation state is zero, that time it will attach by some ligand. Okay, so here you see I choose palladium diphenyl palladium dichloro and triphenyl phosphine. It is also called palladium dichloro. Again, here palladium oxidation state is plus 2, and here I use DBA. DBA means dibenzylidine acetone. It is used as a ligand. Whenever you use this catalyst, whenever you use this type of ligand, that time its oxidation state is 0. That 0 is very effective for reaction. So if you use this one, so no need to use catalyst. If you use this one, you should have to use catalyst. You understood? Not a catalyst, this ligand. Okay, that ligand will stabilize to zero. So that's why I use. Every time they will ask this DBA like that, you have to know what is the basic mechanism, what happened inside. See, this is palladium 4 ligand. That's why I wrote 4L. In presence of, it will reversible. So one will leave, no? So one will leave means, here if one will leave, then palladium is 3, and reversible another 2 will leave. So here palladium oxidation state is 2. Okay, and then it is, how many species is there? 16 electron pieces. It is 16 electron species is there. So if we add, now become releasing 2 electron, now it is 14 electron pieces. And then if you add some halide, alkyl halide, then alkyl and halide group are adding, again it is 16 electron species. You know this oxidative addition and the reductive elimination is there. First step is oxidative reduction, and that is the catalytic cycle. And that alkyl group is further
go to the reaction. So first, palladium catalyst with gold complex with
alkyl halide.
You already know if we use bromo alkyl or like that, and that time you use palladium. So palladium, this alkyl palladium bromo complex will form. So that is simply like that. Now I will explain further. The
first part I wrote that only complex with alkyl halide and palladium catalyst. Now this alkyl halide will coupled with this alkene moiety. That is the very important, and this is already in Haack reaction. And Haack reaction, here I explain, Haack reaction is the alkyl halide treated with simple alkene which containing beta hydrogen. In presence of palladium catalyst, it will coupled, and this is called Haack reaction. Again I explain, alkyl halide containing alkyl halide in presence of palladium catalyst coupled with only simple alkene which contain beta hydrogen undergo coupling reaction and give simple alkene or substituted alkene. So that is the Haack reaction.
So in Haack reaction, see, first part you know the only catalyst is binding. So here is alkene hydro which has a beta hydrogen, and it is LEAP1 ligand, and this is vacancy is there in zero. So this is 14 level of species, and then it will go and that will migrate there. So in migration, here it will like that only. This double bond will reduce and is there. Here one hydrogen is coming. Na? This is called beta hydrogen. Again one ligand will remove. This is adding another ligand, because here is one vacancy is there. Previously it is chelating with this palladium. So this palladium valency is satisfied. So now here this will remove because of this hydrogen. This R group is migrating from here, means migration. Okay, so migration is there, means here valence will reduce, and one ligand whatever he left here, and that will add in here. So here valence will fulfill, and that in presence of, if his beta hydrogen is there, and that will leap. No, see, here one beta hydrogen is there, beta hydrogen elimination, and that will leap, and that will leap, and that will come, and simple substituted alkene is generated. So from simple alkene you have to substituted alkene. So that is this utility of the Haack reaction.
Alkyl halide, this is alkyl group, this is halide, and this is double bond. In presence of palladium catalyst, and this is ligand also, and this is base. Base is for removing the beta hydrogen elimination, that's why base is needed. Okay, so that's why this sulfur is there, and it will coupled, and it will give this like this alkene. No, and see, whatever the alkene is given is trans. See, it is trans, and why it is trans? It is because of this mechanism. Okay, twisting of the mechanism, and this. Here you see OTF means this is also one kind of alkyl halide. Would reflect means one of the living group. It is same function as in bromine chloro. It is like that. So here I use this kind of double bond and palladium, and this is ligand and base. So here it will participate for coupling reaction, and this will form. So you know this previous mechanism, it will form. So in Haack reaction, what happened? You just remember everything in mind every time, because if you don't know this mechanism, sometimes it will also help you for remembering. If you have this double bond, if you use the alkyl halide, so that in presence of catalyst you have to give this one. If you have a double bond and if you this alkyl halide, so in presence of palladium it will give like that. Okay, and third, if you see, third is little bit twisting example. Actually I chose this because it is a little bit twisting. So that halide in presence of palladium catalyst or base in solvent. So here see, cross coupling reactions is what is cross coupling reaction. Here see, I use one organic halide in palladium ligand is there, so it will form like that. No, first you already know. Then I use this RM means R is alkyl group, M means any metal, in not in any metal, some metal is there like tin, some non-metal also boron, and some zinc, magnesium. So that will give this type of product. Ultimately elimination will happen, and this type of alkene, not an alkene, now alkene is formed. Okay, alkene or alkene, whatever is formed. So R1 R dash, this palladium, in this having some mechanism, That mechanism we will explain in this organometallic classes. So you know already oxidative addition and reductive elimination process. In this process is there. So that's why the elimination that we'll discuss there. So you just know the basic. Normally alkali halide palladium used, and this palladium complex will form in presence of some organometallic shred material, that will for complex form, and after that the elimination happen. But in this case you have to know what is this. R1 is there. R1 is almost anything including beta hydrogen. Anything included, any alkali halide including beta hydrogen. Understood? Beta hydrogen it must. And what is the metal? Metal is like MgX, ZnX, copper, tin, silicon, boron, and all boron. We are now you will discuss like that this one with presence of copper and this boron. So this is, if boron is there, it calls Suzuki. If tin is there, it calls Steely. In copper, in presence of copper is there, it is Sonagashira. So that is we will discuss. Now I will go to this, and I use here some organometallic reagent like the zinc bromide. This is zinc alkyl group SF₅, R equal to many R. So this is the one organometallic part, and this is alkyl halide, and it is palladium DBM. You know what is palladium DA, dibenzolidine acetone, is you already know. And this is DHA party, and this is ligand. So in presence of this ligand, basically coupled, no? This portion and this portion are coupled, so this is there. And again I use this another equivalent, and this is OTF is there, no? Previously iodine is there. So this is the reactivity order. Iodine halide will come first and then OTF. So here you understood iodine will first coupled and then OTF is coupled in palladium, so it will get good coupling. So see here I use three ring junction prepared. Understood? That is the utility of coupling. So you see, you never join two phenyl ring like that or three phenyl ring like that. Only coupling, cross coupling procedure, you have to couple many long chain for aromatic coupling, which is called Steely coupling. So this coupling is called why Steely, because in this coupling main function is, this is the organometallic compound, this organometallic compound of the tin. Okay, so this organometallic is a tin. Tin means SN. So this is invaded by centri Steely. So that's why it is called Steely coupling. And it is like that, if you have an like alkyl halide, it is triplet also alkyl halide, and this tin like that, and this is alkene part. This is one organometallic part and this one, and that will coupled in presence of this catalyst. It is called Steely. Here one of the photosynthesis application, you see here tin part is there and here OTF is there. So it will join, no? In presence of, so if anywhere you see this tin part, this halide part, or it would appear like that, so it will couple in presence of palladium catalyst. So that scheme you have to remember in your mind. So see here it is coupled and double bond is gone. Tin moiety, alkyl halide is there, and here you use catalyst. But instead of there, you use another thing, carbon monoxide. So what happened? So in between them, palladium, when palladium is inserted with this alkyl halide, that time carbon monoxide also inserted, and then the tin will couple, tin part moiety will couple. So that's why this is there. So insertion of Cu for application, for your understanding purpose, I give this there. If any this tin alkyl halide, if you give the carbon monoxide, that time you will get this product. So any organoboron, means any organoboron compound is coupled with palladium catalyst with alkyl halide, give an alkene, which is called Suzuki coupling. Again I will say, any organoboron compound in presence of palladium catalyst coupled with alkyl halide or any kind of organic halide, it will give the one normal alkene. It is called Suzuki coupling. So here in this scheme you have to understand what is Suzuki. See what I am saying, I have to generate the organic boron compound. That's why for your understanding purpose I choose this, because of you have to generate, how to generate a organic boron compound, that you have to know. So here I use this kind of triple bond moiety, and I use some this boron reagents. So here hydrogenation will happen, borohydrogenation.
So boron addition is there. So it is adding as a trans group. If it is group like B, so it is like that. One side single phase is there. So hydrogen here come and boron will come. That it is an organoboron, no? It is organoboron. This organoboron in presence of palladium catalyst and base and in alkyl halide or aromatic halide, so it is give like this. This couple happen, this double bond is form this double bond. If it is not double bond, so okay. So that position, that halide will come. So this is the application. This is the application of this Suzuki reaction. Boron compound, alkyl halide, palladium catalyst. You have to get this compound. So here you want to see in whose set the boron is there, that set is coupled. So all the reaction mechanism is like a steely coupling, oxidative addition, reductive elimination process will go. That you will see this organometallic video. So this example I choose because you have to clarify all understanding about the Suzuki reaction. Okay, here I just normal boron and I use one alkene like this kind of purple alkene, and this alkene, you know, this is triple bond type of alkene, and first hydrogenation is happened like that, where because here is steric position, no, so this boron will go to that side. You understood, no? This boron will go to that side. That's why I wrote like that BUST, not whole group. So it is like that only, that side it will go, and it always becomes empty because of the whatever the hydrogenation, whatever the hydroboration will happen by any boron reagent. If the steric group is there, that side hydrogen will add and the remaining side boron will go. Understood? When any type hydroboration is happening, and the less sterically hinted side hydrogen will go, and the less crowded side boron will go. More sterically side hydrogen will go, and less side. And in presence of palladium, this one, in presence of palladium catalyst, so that what happened? In presence of coupling will happen. So in this side, it is there, boron is this side. So that side coupling will happen, na? That side coupling will happen. So see that which side boron is there, that side coupling only happen. So previously bond is Z, trans. So it is E. You know trans is E, and then the remaining side is Z. So that is stereochemistry of the geometry of the double bond is retained in both this case. So first step is the important for this all reaction. So double bond geometry is retained. So you have to get Z alkene. If it is E alkene, you have to get E alkene. If you have a Z, use Z alkene. It is called Z alkene. So that's only depend on the boron position. That will decide this geometry of the double bond. So that example came 2017 or the all over the hydro. Here actually this type of big quantity and boron reagent is there. And it is iodine in presence of palladium catalyst. So see, this double bond is trans, no? So that double bond is remaining trans, and this double bond is cis. So you have to get EZ alkene, no? So this, the geometry of this double bond always be retained in this Suzuki coupling. Understood? Now I have to go another example. This Suzuki reaction. What is this in this reaction? Let us see. You have this kind of boron reagent. If it is boron reagent is there, if you have a halide type this. So previously you see this boron is normal boron. So here is little bit boron and different structure, and this in palladium catalyst that side is going only. And if you see the pyridine type molecule, no? This pyridine second position is more active. So in presence of pyridine also say this boron is there. So see, you have to join also heterocyclic moiety. This nitrogen is there. So you have to see as a pyridine also joining, this aromatic pyridine also joining in this type of reaction. So here is the substituted alkene is also substituted boron reagent, aromatic boron reagent, and substituted aromatic halide also joining, and it's a pyridine type of heterocyclic also coupled. So this is the two different examples for the Suzuki coupling. So Suzuki coupling is every type of organic compound it will happen if it is this condition is there. Okay, now I'll go to the another new reaction. Discuss about the one of the important coupling reaction, which is called Sonagasaria coupling. This coupling reaction is little bit different from others, not a so much different, just only one part. See, previously you see the alkene part, not alkyne. So here is a only coupling reaction for alkyne. See, here is alkenic hydrogen is there, and alkyl or any type of halide, aryl halide, alkyl halide is there. In presence of palladium catalyst, here another metal is needed. It is called copper. Okay, copper is very affectionate to alkyne. Alkyne, not alkyne, alkyne, very affectionate to alkyne. And base is also needed for removing this hydrogen. So this condition is little bit different to previous others. So that's why alkyne part, sonagasida, if it is alkyne, it is called sonagasida. And this, any type of organic halide. And this, this will form. So coupling is triple bond in presence with the alkyne halide. So this is this reaction. What is this mechanism? For your understanding purpose, I wrote simple mechanism. So see, here triethylamine is copper iodate is there. So copper is there. So if it is copper, it is affectionate to this one. So this hydrogen will remove by base and copper is this. So this is the one part. Okay. So and this is C. This is aryl iodide. In presence of palladium, it will keep these things. Okay. It will keep these things. Palladium LLXAR. So this is one of this this palladium complex will form. So these two finally form this complex. Understood? Alkyne moiety and these things. And in presence of palladium zero, I will get this one. So finally, this product is see. So this is this overall simple mechanism. You understood? This palladium catalyst, this alkyne moiety, and this finally give this kind of complex. Alkyne and palladium complex, after that elimination will happen and this is this product. So in this scheme you have to little bit understand of the mechanism as well as the scheme of sonagasida coupling. I give simple this molecule. This is 2-dichloroethylene compound. So I use this alkene, palladium catalyst, copper iodate and this base. So in presence of that it will couple one of this because I use one equivalent. So this will couple and this give this compound. Understood? Okay. So now in this here 2-dichloro is there. So it is trans. Here is cis. So see in this cis, cis is remaining. Okay. This geometry of this double bond and triple bond is same. Which side the Cl is there? That side only coupled there. In this 2 Cl is trans. Same condition I used and I got trans. See, this is already trans. So you understood the first of all the application of the sonagasida and the retention of the bond orientation. So that is the application of sonagasida. And further, if you doing this kind of, and many application will happen. So this is this overall the sonagasida reaction and all of the coupling reaction. So in this video you have to understand the what is the coupling, cross coupling, and three main major coupling, cross coupling reaction, one Heck reaction. So this reaction is very good important for NET exam because one of the step they will definitely ask. And normally I showed here normally mechanism about that thing, because this mechanism I not elaborate so much because it is only application I showing. And in you study that organometallics video, that kind of mechanism will show.